gonna do it again.
Sometimes you're right, even when I hear
like one, yeah.
Like you and me, baby.
Thank you all. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Let me first of all, as I always do, I always thank God first of all for life. And all of the opportunities that God has given me to serve the great city of Memphis. I was born in South Memphis, went to Booker T. Washington. Remember the paradise in the old days, Sunbeam and a whole lot of folks. And to come here tonight, as I approach 80, I'm 79 years old. You know, to come back here and to think about all of the times I used to walk all of the streets in South Memphis because I didn't have no car. I never car. And to come back over here tonight and to see how God is still using me for public service and to look in this audience and to see all of you devoted people who believe in me, and for you all to show up tonight, it really makes me feel real, real good. And there's so many people I want to thank. Randy, come here, man. I'm gonna let you know how old I am. Randy, I met Randy when I was in my 20s. I was teaching fifth grade. And Randy was one of my students, okay? So look how far the Lord has brought us. He's up here now embracing his 79-year-old teacher. I'm watching him. I watched his career with the Barclays. I watched him be the manager of so many wonderful artists. And for Randy to help to organize this event with my dear friend Cliff Dates, I want you all to know that I'm indeed happy to be here tonight, and Randy and all of the artists that are here tonight, I see them. I'm just so happy that you guys think enough of me to come out this evening. And Randy, I love you, son. Love you. I love you, baby. Okay. Judge Joe Brown. Let me tell you about Judge Joe Brown. And Joe, let me tell you what I just sent to UCLA, because I know that's where you went to school. My youngest grandson, he got two rings. He's a, what's called a 440 in the state of Illinois, number one. And they won a basketball team. Out of all of the colleges, he selected UCLA, so he's a freshman there. So I want you to know there's a Harrington at UCLA is going to run in that 440. I know you love Los Angeles, okay? Michael, I see you there, boy. You ain't gonna escape. I knew him when he was a kid too.
My principal.
I used to be his principal. Now, how many of y'all is your principal? I had to put that wood on your head. Y'all don't want to stand up, do you? Okay. I know. You know, when I was principal, man, I had to tighten that ass up if you got out of sight. They don't do that no more, Judge. They don't do that no more in school, right? Randy will tell you that, huh?
And you bring it back.
You're right. But let me Cliff Davis. Cliff, where are you? Where's Cliff?
He's outside.
Just sit on it. Cliff and Friends for Harrington. Friends for Harrington are the groups that are sponsoring this event. They're the ones that got all of these wonderful artists and this great comedian. and Randy to put this event on. So I want to thank you all for coming, all of the sponsors that are here. Now let me tell you why I'm running for mayor again.
All right, we need you.
The judge really laid the case out.
Yeah.
Now I'm not going to brag. I don't want y'all to think I'm bragging.
It's okay.
I don't need to do this.
No, you don't.
For no egoism. I don't need to do it for the little money they're going to pay me. But let me tell you why I need to do this. I left you all in the half of my fifth term. And I was on Thaddeus Matthews' show and I told the world why I left. And I want y'all to know real quick why I left and why I got to go back, and then I'm going to sit down. If you all will remember the last 2 years when I was in office, the powers to be tried to assassinate my character.
Every term.
They tried to send me to prison. How many of y'all remember that? Man, they tried to convince you that I stole a garage down to the pyramid. Now how the hell am I going to steal a damn garage? They put it in the newspaper, then I had some of y'all haters say, yeah, that damn Harrington, he stole it. I'm serious. Damn in the newspaper, Judge. Said I stole a $20 million garage. The Greyhound bus station, they tried to say I did something inappropriate. They wiretapped me. They followed me for 2 years. The newspapers every day depicting me as a criminal. Do y'all remember that? Now, put a pin in that. My dear mother, I'm going to get to that. What you didn't know was every day I left while I was superintendent of mayor, I went to see my mom. And if the weather was nice, I sat on the porch with my mom. That's on Barden Street. I met a guy here in a few minutes. He talked to me about Barden and Latham. Where is it? You know what I'm talking about. Where is it? Barden and Latham. Okay. So I would go see my mom. So, mom, I said, Mom, stop looking at television. Stop looking at the newspaper. She said, Willie, she said, why are you still doing this? And I said, Mom, don't worry. I said, I'm going to beat this. Ain't nothing going to happen. So it was depressing my mama. Then I couldn't focus. Let me tell you something in life, and the judge will tell you that. Let me tell you some people you don't ever want on your case. You don't want a U.S. Attorney's Office. You don't want the FBI. And you don't want IRS. And you don't want the media. I had all four of them on my ass at the same time. I'm just keeping it real with you. And Judge, it was hurting my mom. So I said, Mom, I said, I'll tell you what, baby. We'll take care of this. So I eased out in the second half of the fifth year. Now, y'all, that's the real deal. Can you understand how I felt seeing my mom hurt? I could handle it. So I left. And Judge, I left and I didn't leave it in good hands. Warden was a disaster.
Yes, he was.
And to me, he embarrassed black manhood.
Yes, he did.
The strength of the office. And that's why Strickland beat him overwhelmingly. Mr. Strickland does not have a base. Warden was just that bad. That's why Strickland won. Now, it's time for Strickland to go. I had some young people, Michael, they kept saying, well, Harrington, he too old. Why, they say too old. Let's get a young person. So I looked all out there and I said, well, I can't see him. I can't find him. I'm looking. I can't find him. Where's that young person? I said, anybody can run, but hell, I ain't talking about run, I'm talking about winning. Yeah, anybody can run. Well, you can pay $100 and get 25 signatures, you run. So I decided that I could not sit on the sideline. You heard the judge talk about the crime rate. He's absolutely right. But these young people are going buck wild, man. We got to bring that stuff in. We got to have that in. I'm not God. I can't wave a magic wand, but I think I can get their attention. You know, it's this whole culture of hopelessness. A lot of our folks, like, they ain't got nothing to look up to.
Bring them some hope.
You got to bring them some hope. Are you following me? I meet these kids, man, and you know, some of them come up with some hard circumstances of life. I came up, I understand the streets. You know what I'm saying? We got to show them that there's a different way of life. We got to give them vocational, technical training. We got to give them a mentoring program. All of that good stuff. You talking about? That's what I'm talking about. When I went to high school, man, we had shop. I'm talking real deal. Everybody don't need to go to college, but every man needs to be able to make a living. We got to bring that back. That's what I'm talking about, okay? Mentoring programs. We got to connect churches to reality. Don't get me talking about some of these preachers, man. Hey. Did y'all see what happened last week, Judge?
Yeah.
It happened before. Let me tell you what preachers did. And I love Dr. Martin Luther King. If y'all will remember, there were black preachers.